Worthy President, Honorable Guests, Respected Teachers and dear Students, Assalamu Alaikum. Today, in this gathering, I am going to speak on a very burning, important and authentic topic, that is we and our environment. First of all, let me explain it to you that what the environment is. In fact, our surroundings are known as our environment. Allah Almighty conferred this beautiful universe to man, which had all those needs, utilities and facilities which a man needs. And Allah Almighty has announced in the Holy Quran in Surah Rahman, A'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajeem. It means that in the sense that Allah Almighty has made everything of the universe subdued for man. But alas, I am saying this story that man did not thank Allah for his blessing. Instead, he destroyed his balance from his life. And this destruction of the balance is known as environmental pollution. Honorable guests, in all the religions, chastity, purity, cleanliness and neatness are considered to be as the first position. But in our religion, Islam, it is considered to be half religion. As the Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, proclaimed, At-tahuru nisful iman. It means, cleanliness is the half of Islam. Dear students, remoteness from the religious values, fearlessness toward Islam, not keeping the fast, leaving the prayers, underestimating the power of Allah Almighty, and earnings of profit, insurance and interest. These are the main reasons, these are the prominent reasons which have disturbed man's life. Honorable guests, expulsion and evacuation of smoke and noise from various sorts of industries, old and future means of communication in the third class world. Misuse of fungicides and pesticides, harming sprays of dangerous chemicals on the crops, and empty boxes of juice and milk on the roads, which are thrown on the roads. These are the prominent reasons which have disturbed man's life and have overtaken the humans into the cancer of lungs, sympathy of nose, eyes, ears, heart, bones and joints. Dear audience, trees are the great gifts of nature. To grow it and to protect it is a continuous propitiation. But alas, now this continuous propitiation is under the striking of axes and saws. Due to the unusual increasing daily temperature of the universe, now more than half world is suffering from floods and storms. The not needed cutting of forests is totally against the laws, rules, morals and values of Islam and is disturbing the wildlife. Let me tell you one thing more. It's very interesting to know. According to the sociologists, in a country, the minimum amount of forest should be 25%. But in our country, unfortunately, its amount is only 2.3%. How much loss is this for Pakistan? Dear students, oceans, seas, rivers, canals, ponds and streams are being polluted by dangerous chemical matter and various pollutants, due to which aquatic life is being disturbed and destroyed. The end of which is definitely the end of humanity. This mammal-like piece of sovereign areas, this in which area we are living, this mammal-like piece of sovereign areas, in which I, you, we all are enjoying the natural beauties and the comeliness is being disturbed and destroyed due to our carelessness. Now that for this action is needed, that we all, as we consider our home or home, as such as that, we should consider this whole universe of our home. I think this is the only solution for this problem. May Allah keep us victorious. May Allah help us. May Allah keep our flag flying up over the sky. Thank you very much. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. सामीन, जैसा कि आप जानते हैं आज तक इस तकरीब का हम यहाँ पर दिखाने की कोशिश कर रहे हैं कि हर छोटे बड़े क्लास से तमाम बच्चे जो हैं उन पर इंफरादी तवज्जो दी जा रही है और इसी मरहले को रवां करते हुए मैं थ्री क्लास से ईशा और उसके ग्रुप को एक पॉइंट की परफॉर्मेंस के लिए इन्वाइट करता हूँ। ईशा और ग्रुप उसका